We have Mahmoud Hashemi on restructuring data in Python.
Good evening, Cleveland. We're excited for some Python, I see. They say you should start a presentation with a quote, so I've got one here for you. It's one I think you've all heard before. Flat is better than nested by Tim Peters, PEP 20, a little while ago, otherwise known as the Zen of Python. So with that Zen moment, we move into a new quote. Namespaces are one honking great idea. Let's do more of those. That's also Tim Peters, PEP 20, the Zen of Python. So, you know, these two statements in tension are a lot to meditate on. And I think that meditation may have been lost or maybe just not available to all the Java developers in the world because we end up with data that looks like this. And note the ellipses. This goes far off the page. So, and it gets a lot worse when you get into enterprise environments and aren't just dealing with web services. So, what do we do about this reality? Glom! It's a tool that is the nested data operator for Python. No longer is flat strictly better than nested. It's a choice that you can make. Truly Zen. All right, you can find it now. It's on GitHub. Please have a look. But let me talk to you about what it actually does. So first up, I think this is maybe the most common case, and the first few times I wrote something like this, this is what it did. Basically, it gave you a dotted syntax for reaching into dictionaries. You know, basically here we have a target, galaxy, system, planet, Jupiter, not a great structure for the data, but with Glom, it's no problem, right? You can just move straight ahead. But it goes but see, here's the whole reason you need that in the first place. If you have a line like this, right? Basically, you could get four different exceptions. Now, experienced developers are going to actually split this up into a bunch of different try-except blocks, but it still gets to be pretty tedious. For these last two exceptions, none-type object has no attribute get item, and list indices must be integers, I encourage you to figure out which of the data structures actually had this problem, the one where I'm accessing B or the one where I'm accessing C. What we need is we need good error messages, right? It's more than just a dotted syntax for reducing lines of code. It actually gives you an error message that says path access error, could not access C in index 2 of path ABC, got error. You know, it gives you the underlying error. And you're definitely no worse off than when you started, and in fact, much better. But it goes much further than just access, right? Because what I realized over the years is that I don't just need to access one field, I need to access a whole series of them to build a new object. And what I get there is basically I should be able to accept more than just strings as input. Instead, in this case, we've extended the data structure to add Earth with our one moon and Jupiter with its 69 moons. And, you know, I want a list of names and a list of moon counts. And with Glom, you can do that. You just say, give me a data structure that looks like this. So it's related to the list comprehension. I love list comprehensions because the data that you get out looks like the code itself. And in this case, it's similar. You declare a structure, hand it the target, and it renders something like this. And so for this kind of system, we've just sort of ended up calling it like an object template. You know how when you're making an HTML template, like with Django or something like that, you basically say, oh yeah, take this value and put it in this div, and take this value and make an you know, unordered list from it. Here, it's very similar, except you're saying, take this object and please make it into a dictionary. Take this object and please make it into a list, so on and so forth. So to review, we have path-based access, declarative data transformation, and readable, meaningful error messages. And to go a little further, features I don't have time for, it has built-in data exploration and debugging tools. So right now, I have Glom specs, as I call them, that are dozens of lines long, replacing code that's hundreds of lines long. And but at the same time, it can be kind of complicated to debug. So it actually has a built-in debugger thing. And it even has a command line tool. It's like JQ, but there's no DSL. You just write Python. So, yes, with that, I would encourage you to pip install Glom today. And if you want to know more, I've written a blog post about it. It's at that URL, sedimental.org. And also, there's an open session tomorrow at 4 p.m. Hope to see you in room 10. Thank you very much.